Hey everyone, as you may or may not know, in 2024, I've been using AI to create graphics for t-shirts with my Design with Detour. I've been creating a design a day using AI art. And in this video, I wanted to share with you my top 12 favorite AI arts that I came up with, or ChatGPT came up with. And I'm gonna show you the art that it came up with, the prompt that it came up with, as well as the t-shirt that I designed with it. So in this video, you'll see all of them. You can copy these prompts and try it out for yourself on either ChatGPT or any other AI, and hopefully it works out well for you. So let's get into it. I'm gonna go into ChatGPT first, then show you the t-shirt, and we'll take it from there. All right, so here I am on ChatGPT. As you can see, I've been using ChatGPT for months. If I scroll down here, here's November, October, and so on. Just I've done a ton of these. So I'm not gonna show you all of them, just the ones that I think were the best of the month. So let's start with January. Here's January's one that I thought was the best. This is that strawberry jam jar jamming out with the guitar. And so I wrote this text here, or this prompt, to try and get it, but I think the prompt that you want to see is this one. So here you go. A cartoon strawberry jam jar with sunglasses playing an electric guitar designed as a die cut sticker. The jar should have a face, arms, and legs looking energetically and lively. The electric guitar should be detailed and colorful, complementing the jam jar's playful demeanor. The sticker has a solid white background and a strong black border surrounding the white die cut border and no shadow. The style is a digital drawing, vibrant and appealing for a sticker design. Now that last part's gonna always be there for probably all of them, because this is using the GPT called Sticker Wiz, and that's kind of how they do it, with the white outline here and a black border. So I really like this because it makes it easy for you to cut out. You don't have to put that in if you're using other GPTs, but I would suggest putting either a white background or a black background so that you can remove it. So it came out really cool. I love this cartoony style, and I'll show you what it looks like on a t-shirt. All right, so here I am on TeePublic. I actually uploaded this design to Amazon, TeePublic, and Redbubble. If you've watched my videos about my Design with Detour videos that I do every month, kind of recap, you've seen that I've uploaded there. And you can see it's on sale right now, but this is the design on the t-shirt. I actually added a yellow circle in the background, some graphics around it. Obviously, I cut out the background from the sticker and then just put the words jamming on here in a nice vintage kind of font. So nice 70 vintage font. And I think it came out okay. I've actually sold some of these already on both TeePublic and I think Amazon. I'm not quite sure, but yeah, this was one of my favorite t-shirts for that month, and I like how it came out. So my favorite AI art graphic from February was this one right here. It came out great. All I put is a crab shape, but filled with the Maryland flag inside as my prompt, my simple prompt. But the prompt that ChatGPT came up with was a little more detailed. Here it is. I'm not gonna read this whole one, but you can see that it does have something about a sticker here. So you don't need to put that in if you're doing it, but I think a lot of this can help when you're creating AI art for other AI stuff. But to look at the detail here, I love how ChatGPT does it. That nice black border makes it easy, and the white background makes it easy to take the white out so that I only have the black border. So, you know, I can either put a white around it or I can leave it on a white background for my t-shirt, and I'll show you how that came out. I'm gonna add some words here, and I think it came out great for the t-shirt as well, but this would make a great sticker just by itself. So here is the shirt on TeePublic. You can see I used the word Baltimore because that was the Baltimore flag, or Maryland flag, and I just did kind of an arc right here. I believe I did this in Kittle, but you can do it in Affinity Designer and Illustrator, just kind of arc that part of it just to match, you know, the shape that was there with the claws. And then Charm City right here, because that's the kind of the nickname of Baltimore, and then when it was established. So I think it came out great. I put it on a white background, but I could have easily changed Baltimore to white and put a white outline around this and kind of changed it for black as well. So and it goes on other things right here. You can see it makes a great sticker, and hoodie, tank top, even a mug was great. In March, my favorite AI art from ChatGPT was this one right here. It says artist, and I sold a bunch of these on TeePublic. I'm gonna click on here so you can see how cool it is. Look at that, really nice. Kind of hard to remove the white background, but if you do that trick in Affinity Photo, it's kind of easy because it just takes out the white. And let me show you the prompt here. There you go. You can use that, try that and see what happens by using that. And I think this one also says, well, the splatter art style, I think just having a white background worked really well. I love this splatter style, even though it's a little hard to remove the background with it, but I think visually it's really cool. And here is the t-shirt, what it ended up looking like. And I just added the words, I am an artist, right? And still kept all the other things here. This is kind of a brush front and it turned out great. I love how it looks. And I sold a bunch of these, like I said, on TeePublic. It is one of my top three selling shirts for Design with Detour in 2024. I think some group probably bought it, artist group, and they bought a ton of it at once. So really happy for that. So here's my favorite design or art, AI art that ChatGPT did in May for me, or in April, sorry, we'll get to May soon. And this is this flamingo right here. You can see I just did a very simple prompt, cartoon flamingo getting ready for summer by drinking and wearing sunglasses and all of that. But and look how cool that is. But if we go to here, this is the actual prompt that you might want to use. This is the prompt that ChatGPT made with my simple prompt, and this is a little more detailed. So I really like this one and how it came out. It has kind of that cool style with the shadows and highlights and everything, and it's just really cool. So I like it. Usually the tube is the flamingo, but this time the flamingo is in the tube, which is kind of neat. So this is the shirt that I ended up doing with this design. You can see I knocked out the background, that white background. I put in a vintage sunset and just put bro, we out, and then put teachers underneath. This is a really simple layout. If you have a vintage sunset, you can kind of arc the text around the top and the bottom, and it works out well. You'll see a lot of layouts like this with t-shirts. It's just a great, easy layout for people to do, and it turns out well, especially with something with colors. So this is the AI art that was my favorite in May, and this is a golf or a dolphin golfing. So a golfin, I guess that's what I called it. So I said, make the dolphin concentrating on hitting the ball. I tried it earlier when have a dolphin swinging at a golf ball and it did this. And then I put in another text and it did this. And I really like the cartoon style here. That's one thing I really love about ChatGPT is it really knows how to do this cartoony kind of style. And it does like that shading with the highlights and the shadows. Really cool. Here's a closer look at it. Even the golf ball. Check that out. So here is the prompt and you can use that. A digital drawing of a die cut sticker. Sometimes they put the die cut sticker thing in the front, but if you want to copy all that, you can try that out on your various AI apps and see what comes out for you. But I really like the look of it and how he's holding the golf club and everything just turned out great. And the white outline just makes it easy to remove that background. So here is the shirt that I came up with this design, this AI art. You can see it's similar to the one that I did before with the text, bigger text on the top, but I did two lines of text on the bottom and I added some palm trees on the side just to give it that tropical look. And the vintage sunset's just one color instead of many colors, more so to highlight the design that's in the front. So no competing colors with the dolphin here, just one color back there. And I think that gives it, it makes it pop. And I did do that pun, golfin instead of dolphin. So I did golfin, dolphin, swing with purpose. So two puns on here for this t-shirt. So in June, this was my favorite AI art from ChatGPT. It's this giant cat, kind of a Catzilla thing, bigger like a kaiju cat. And I just put a giant kaiju cat destroying a Japanese city with a big red circle behind it, which is cool because I love red and black, kind of that combo. And then we're going to click on here. You can see how cool detailed it is, that line art. And the prompt is right here. Very short prompt from ChatGPT, and it still worked. I like it. So I'll show you what I came up with. Tried to do a cool design with this one with Japanese text and everything. So here's the shirt, what it came out looking like, and I put the incredible Catzilla, and I added some helicopters here, took away that text that was there in the original, added the text down here, which is Catzilla, and then I put King of the Posters, trying to do that double pun again, which is funny, and I added this like meow right here. I love that you can choose different colors in TeePublic, and I like how it looks different than some of these other Catzilla ones. And the stickers and everything came out well. In July, my favorite AI art was this one with the chicken nuggets sitting in some sauce here. And I tried to make it look like a hot tub. And you can see I tried so many different ways. So this one didn't turn out. And I tried after and these didn't turn out. So this was my favorite one right here. And let me show you the prompt here that ChatGPT came up with. And there you go, hanging out, relaxing in the sauce. Originally, it was just going to be one sauce, but they kind of made the kind of different colors with mustard and barbecue, I guess, is what these are. And it turned out great, though. It looks like they're chilling in a hot tub of hot sauce or chicken nugget sauce. And this is what I ended up doing for the t-shirt. I just did the two words saucy nugs, kind of put it in the background and cut out that background. And you can see kind of a white outline so that it stands out a little bit better on this red. And I really like it on this red, but of course you can do it in different colors. I've sold a bunch of these on Amazon as well, changing out some of the words and doing it more like a scale design and doing it on white as well as black. So I didn't do that here on TeePublic, but on Amazon, I was able to kind of do this multiple times as a scale design. In August, this was my favorite AI design. This is a octopus reading a book, and you can see I tried to do it a couple times with the octopus doing different things. And at first he was playing the drums, and then it just said, I want to use the same style, but make him reading books. And it turned out great. And this is the prompt that ChatGPT came up with. You can see it's a little longer there, but I love the way that it did, like the tentacles here and the books came out right with the bookmarks and his face. I love the highlights and the shadows on this, just looks really cool. This is what the t-shirt ended up looking like. I had a longer text here, so many arms, but not enough books. I think I came up with that, or ChatGPT helped me come up with that. I didn't know really what to do, but I knew I wanted it something related to books, and I filled in the space with some hearts here. And I really like how it turned out. This is really original, and I don't think I've seen this before. So I like that it's different and it just has really nice artwork. So in September, this was my favorite one. Look at the detailed on this raven. I did a couple of ravens and different things, but this one with the skull just turned out great. I love the detail on his, again, with the shadows and the highlights and just the detail on this right here. I love how it turned out. Here is the prompt. You can see that really detailed prompt, but the way that ChatGPT does their artwork, that's why I continue to use it, because I'm just amazed on how well this turned out. So of course I had to make the t-shirt on a black t-shirt, and I found this kind of text right here, more of old-timey kind of gothic looking text, and I put it in a frame, or kind of breaking out of this frame because the shape had kind of a rounded shape up here, so I thought that would work well, and then kind of did these curly things here, and I think it turned out great. I like how it came out, and the word nevermore kind of matches the raven and everything, so it gave it a chance, because it's just white and thin lines, gave the artwork a chance to kind of stand out. So in October, this was my favorite AI, continuing with the rocker theme. This is Rocker Santa. Originally, I just did this Santa with glasses and two hands up, and then I said, make it more rocker, and it did. It's really cool. So let me zoom in here. Look at the detail of this, the black nails. I didn't say to put that, and the band with these sticking out, like really rocker, pretty cool. Here is the prompt that ChatGPT came up with. Just has that rebellious expression, strong rock and roll attitude, all those kinds of things. Just amazing artwork. and love all the details that they put in. Even though I just said make it more rocker, it added a lot of the rocker details. But here's what the t-shirt design ended up looking like. I used Kittle for this one. They have so many cool fonts and backgrounds for rocker stuff. So this font right here, Xmas Rockstar, was a cool font on Kittle. I think it's called Boxtrot or something. It could be something else, but they have a bunch of them out there, and they already had templates with kind of this style. So I just swapped out the graphic in the middle, put Santa, Rocker Santa in, and then changed the words, and it came out great. I think having the, like I said before, the white as your text and the background kind of gives your design a chance to shine. So I'm not competing with the color in the design because it's white, but it does have some style with it too. So it has that rocker style with the fonts that I chose. So it just worked out well in that tall rectangle shape. Turned out cool. I really like this. I actually bought one of these as a hoodie, so a red hoodie. In November, this was my favorite AI artwork from ChatGPT. ChatGPT can do rocker stuff, gothic stuff, as well as kawaii stuff. Look at this one right here. I had to work on this one a couple of times because it messed up the face, but eventually I got it. And this was the prompt right there. So Grim Reaper on a unicorn, which I really thought was cool. And they made the colors a little bit different to match, you know, the gray and the white here. I think having that different color rainbow kind of makes it stand out. And this is what I ended up doing. I think I made a video for this one, or could be a shorts that I did for this one, but it came out really cool. I just used death metal here in pink and put a cloud right here and a bunch of stars and some clouds in the background. And most of it was the original with that same color, pink and orange, yellow, rainbow, just turned out really well. So I like how this turned out, a nice kawaii style, but then, you know, having this kind of more metal design, or I guess this is a metal font, but it just worked out well because it's rounded and everything else, and the kawaii stuff is rounded too. And finally, in December, this was my favorite AI design in December. And you can see it's this line, kind of this reggae line with dark glasses. I did it twice. So this was the original one, maybe more than twice. Let me see. Oh yeah. So I started over here, Rastafari line. That kind of is cool, but I didn't want that diagonal. And then it kind of did a weird thing with the eyes, but then that turned out really great. Here is the prompt for those of you that want to try it on AI. But look at the detail on this too, again, with the shadows and the highlights. Really cool, and the dreadlocks just worked out well. So here's what the t-shirt ended up looking like. Kept it really simple. It did the green, yellow, red in the background, and then solid yellow text back here using my favorite font, Veneer. So you can see reggae roots, and I think it turned out great. So I really like it on black, but it can work on some other colors here, but I think black makes it stand out and gives it pop because the yellow here. So there you go. Those are my top 12 AI art from ChatGPT for my Design with Detour. Remember, I did Design a Day, so there's a ton more on there. Originally, my plan was to give you all of those in my downloads. I've done January, February, and March. I'll put the link down here, but you can see that on my digital downloads. Each one, each topic, or each day, I did 4 designs. And so if you get those prompts, you'll get 100 designs each month, or 100 prompts, over 100 prompts each month because I did 4. So in total, I had over 1,000 AI art designs from ChatGPT this year. Not all of them were great, but a lot of them were, and I used a lot of them for t-shirts. So hopefully you've learned a lot. I had so much fun doing Design with Detour this year. I'm going to do something next year, something different, but the prompts will always be there on my digital downloads. Like I said, I'll put the prompt again down there. If you like this video, make sure to watch some of my other ones that I did. I'll put how I used the ChatGPT art to make a t-shirt, one of my first ones here, so you can learn how to do that. Thanks again for watching. Hopefully you had fun doing Design with Detour, and keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.